Moving on to the city manager's report, Mr. Lahanas.
Thank you, Your Honor. I have one item of information to share with the city council. It actually relates to the comments made by Mr. Anderson both now and at the meeting in December, in which he questioned if the city had done any active steps to help retain Barnes & Noble. I appreciate his kind words regarding response, but I also have to share that praise with the city council. A number of council members, including Councilmember Baird, specifically requested that we respond to Mr. Anderson, and we did that. So that should be shared with council as well. I would like to also call Mr. Dempsey forward. The letter that was referenced by Mr. Anderson was prepared by the planning department. I'll request that Mr. Dempsey read that into the record for council's information on the information and questions raised about Barnes & Noble. Thank you.
Good evening, Mayor and council members. As Mr. Anderson indicated, we put together a document called the Barnes & Noble Closing, the City of East Lansing Perspective, and I'm going to provide that information so that our public can get a sense of what was in that document. The building in question where Barnes & Noble was a tenant is owned by City Center Partners II, LLC. This is a partnership that was formed in 2000 to redevelop and subsequently own this property as part of the larger City Center redevelopment project. As the landlord, they offered significant rent concessions to Barnes & Noble to retain them as a tenant. They worked closely with the retailer for several years prior to the official announcement, seeking ways to reduce Barnes & Noble's cost and also to find new revenue sources. One area of focus for the city was working with MSU administration to see if Barnes & Noble could take over MSU's textbook business. However, existing contractual obligations prevented that option. In addition, this option may have negatively impacted other long-term downtown businesses that sell textbooks. The only other viable option was a direct rent subsidy for the retailer. After analyzing this potential cost, calculated to be in hundreds of thousands of dollars over just a few years, it was determined the Downtown Development Authority simply did not have the fiscal resources to provide such a significant subsidy. There was also serious concern regarding the long-term viability of the store, even if a rent subsidy were to be provided. In the end, the timing of their lease expiring and their profitability challenges were simply too much to overcome. Barnes & Noble also faced significant pressure on the revenue side. To say that the bookstore business is changing rapidly would really be an understatement. The rapid emergence of e-readers and e-books has been astounding. Amazon reported recently they sold 1 million e-readers per week in the month of December. We are witnessing a revolutionary change in publishing that started with the decline of printed newspapers and is now moving to books and magazines. Some retail analysts have questioned whether Barnes & Noble, as a traditional bricks and mortar bookstore chain, will survive, possibly facing a fate similar to Borders. To illustrate this point further, the Georgetown, meaning the Washington, D.C., Barnes & Noble location, was closed on December 31st of this year, the same date that ours was closed at the termination of their 10-year lease. This followed on the heels of four other bookstores closing in the District of Columbia. The closure of multiple outlets in a larger, higher density urban environment illustrates well the challenge of retaining bookstores as this industry rapidly evolves or devolves, depending on your viewpoint. We are facing an issue that no way is isolated to downtown East Lansing. Recognizing that this is a key downtown retail space, we have been working with City Center Partners to market the space to other retailers. We have met with the CCP management team and provided them with updated market information for use in their marketing efforts. They have been in ongoing conversations with a national brokerage firm to potentially hire them to market that space, certainly a considerable challenge in the current marketplace. CB Richard Ellis, a local commercial brokerage firm, has recently reported that the Lansing region has a retail vacancy rate of 20% and that nearly 175,000 square feet of additional retail space became vacant in 2011. The biggest challenge right now is that Michigan has been blacklisted for the past several years by most national retailers. While there are indications that this is starting to change, that data indicates it will take time to fill any retail space, especially of this size. Our strategy in recent years with retail has been to target a couple of key niches that residents and visitors have continually requested. The first is a grocery store. We have implemented a direct marketing campaign to secure a grocery operator and also explored extensively the option of relocating the East Lansing Food Co-op to downtown. We have also targeted hardware stores and more upscale restaurants. We are now expanding our efforts to identify potential large space users that would fit into the vacant Barnes & Noble space. Beyond retail, we have worked to diversify the overall business base in our downtown. We have added over 20 high-tech startup companies in our Technology Innovation Center and nearby properties. We have also added year-round population with owner-occupied housing. Both of these are important in helping support retailers that fear their businesses will fall off dramatically in the summer months. One part of this effort includes a new economic development website that includes a list of available properties in downtown, among many other features. City staff and the DDA will continue to work on this challenge and will assist City Center partners in any way we can to fill the void left by Barnes & Noble. The final decision on a new user will ultimately be left to City Center partners, as this is a privately owned retail space. Our hope is that our combined efforts will identify a user or users that can generate pedestrian and economic activity and further add to downtown's vibrancy. Downtown East Lansing survived the closure of Jacobson's. It will survive the closure of Barnes & Noble. Thank you.